Okay, just a brief video on the subject of prayer. Wanted to share a little insight, a situation that I experienced recently. On prayer, like all of us, we take to heart what we read in Matthew chapter 6, beginning with verse 5, when Jesus said, "When you pray, you are not to be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on the street corners, so that they may be seen by men. Truly I say to you, they have their reward in full. But you, when you pray, go into your inner room, close your door, and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you." And indeed, this is a reality, and none of us really question that. Could be that we'd like to see positive answers to our prayer much more frequently than what we've been experiencing, but we know that the principle is sound. If Jesus said it, then obviously it must be so. Prayer, however, is much more important than a lot of us give credit to. It's very, very important that we pray at the beginning of our day. Yes, it's great to pray in the evening, and if you just know that you can't do it in the morning, well, God certainly is not going to strike you dead for it, but it will work to your advantage if you can squeeze in your prayer time earlier in the day, and then if you also want to pray in the evening, go ahead and do it. Now, here's what I wanted to share with you. Most of us, I guess, I shouldn't say all, have dealt with the Motor Vehicle Administration. Visiting the MVA is always the highlight of our decade, is it not? When we get to go and stand in long lines of impatient people, putting up with frustrated clerks, and perhaps spending hours there at the MVA and experiencing our own little nightmares as we renew our license or do get some title work done for our car, etc., etc. My license renewal was coming up. I had a couple of weeks to go, but I didn't want to wait until the last minute. I really wanted to go the previous week, but something had come up in the weather, I think it weather related, and I wasn't able to make it. So now this week I'm thinking I really need to do this. And so I set Wednesday as the time that I was going to go up to the MVA and renew my license. And you know how it is, things in the morning happen one after another, slow me down. I'm not getting out. I didn't want to leave too early and be part of the early morning rush, but late morning. And maybe that way I'd find a little bit of a lull in traffic as opposed to early morning and lunchtime. Well, you know, the best laid plans of mice and men oftentimes go astray. And this was no different. One thing left after the other, and it's getting later and later. And I'm thinking, okay, I'm not going to make it Wednesday, but Thursday shouldn't be too bad. I'll wait until Thursday. And then it was just had a sensation, a feeling that, or a leading that I should do it today anyway. But I haven't prayed yet. I haven't spent a minute or two in prayer, but I haven't really had a prayer time this day. And the morning's getting late, and I have things to do at the MVA. But right is right. And I've read that Martin Luther and many other of the great Christians throughout time have said things along the line of, when I know I have a busy day ahead of me, that's when I spend the most time in prayer in the morning. So once again, I took that to heart. And so even though I was running late and my day was not going the way I had hoped it would go, I did take time to have an unhurried time of prayer with my Father in heaven. And did not rush through anything. He gave me the patience, I guess, that I needed, that I could touch all bases, bring up to him all the things that were concern for me, and making prayer requests for family and friends. And then I got in the car and rode over to the MVA expecting the worst because it's now noon and the lunchtime crowd, the people have probably already started coming in. Let me tell you what happened at the MVA. I walked in the door of the MVA and they have two lines there. In the one line, it's a few people having their car-related business taken care of. But in the second line, which is for license-related things, there is no line. Okay, so I walk up to the counter, and almost to the counter, I stop because I'm thinking the lady's probably busy at the desk and it's going to be a few minutes. I'll wait for her to call me. I stay back at the where the rope indicates. But almost immediately, she calls me, and I go forward. I tell her what I'm there for, and she says, okay, here's your number. Wait for your number to be called, and then go to that window. Okay, I thank her. I walk away, and I start looking around the MVA, trying to orient myself to the layout. Where am I going to be going, and where do I even see these numbers? Memory told me that they flashed them up on a screen, but I'm not seeing a screen. It may be there, but I never did see a screen. But while I'm trying to orient myself, they call out my number. I haven't even sat down yet. And so I go over to the lady. We go through the routine. She asks me the relevant questions. I give her the paperwork. I pay for 8 years of renewal on my driver's license. And I walk out, and I didn't put a stopwatch on it, but I'm sure I was not there in the MVA for more than 15, at the most 20 minutes, renewing my driver's license. And I really think it was because of the leading of the Lord. I took time to go ahead and pray anyway, even though I was running late. I just thought, if God wants me to go now, then he's not going to have any problem with me spending time in prayer. The message, I think, is here for you, that we need to always remember just how important prayer is, even in the smooth functioning of our normal day-to-day routines. Make time every day without fail to calmly, relaxedly talk with your Father about the things that concern you. Yes, start off with praise and recognizing who He is. He's Almighty God, creator and sustainer of heaven and earth. He is perfect in every way whatsoever. He is the only one in all existence worthy to be worshipped, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And He's reached out to you, and He saved you. And not only saved you from eternal damnation in hell, that would have been enough, but He also adopts you into His family so that now you can actually call Him. He really is your perfect Heavenly Father, and He loves you with an unfailing love. And take that time to share your concerns and your praise for Him, and go into the things that are bothering you, the things that you're happy about, and just spend some real time talking with your Father at the beginning of the day, and see if that does not change the quality of your life dramatically. Take time to talk to your Father in heaven. Deal? I sure hope so. You have a good day. Amen.